Tornadoes are one of the most extreme and dangerous phenomena in the world. They're wind vortices with a great capacity to destroy everything in their path. Part of their destructive capacity is that they are very difficult to predict. Currently, tornadoes only form in very few areas of the world, but that could be about to change. Some scientists speculate that due to climate change, tornadoes could begin to form in areas where they have never been seen before. They could also become larger and more destructive due to temperature changes in the atmosphere, which could end up forming super tornadoes. How dangerous would these super tornadoes be, and what could we do to avoid them? Stay with us until the end to find out. Since the beginning of time, tornadoes have wreaked havoc and destruction in their path, leaving a trail of devastation that survivors will never forget. A tornado is a weather phenomenon characterized by a rotating air column extending from a storm cloud to the Earth's surface. Although these columns of rotating air can vary in size, duration, and intensity, they share a common characteristic: they are extremely dangerous. To understand how we might face super tornadoes in the future, we must first understand conventional tornadoes and how they form. For a tornado to form, very specific atmospheric conditions are required, which are divided into different stages. The first necessary condition is the presence of an unstable atmosphere. This means that there must be a significant difference in temperature and humidity between different layers of the atmosphere, which creates a vertical gradient of temperature and pressure. This instability can be caused by various factors, including solar radiation, the convergence of wind at the surface, and a warm air mass colliding head-on with a moist air mass. This difference in temperatures between the layers causes an oscillation that results in fast, strong winds that eventually form a tornado. Of course, this scenario does not occur spontaneously, and the only way something like this can happen is through more significant phenomena such as cold fronts or areas of convergence of winds such as mountains and plains near the Earth's poles. These systems can provide the energy needed to fuel the storm and create the right conditions for tornadoes to form. It shouldn't be forgotten that most tornadoes originate from supercell-type storms, which are long-lasting, large-scale storms with a persistent rotation within them. These storms can generate long upward winds that can generate and maintain the rotation necessary to form a tornado. Finally, the last ingredient to form a tornado is wind clashes. Remember that warm air tends to rise while cold air tends to go down. So when two air masses of different temperatures collide head-on, one tries to rise while the other tries to go down. This produces a rotation of air masses, and if this occurs within a supercell-type storm, the rotation of the wind can change direction and go from horizontal to vertical, thus generating a mesocyclone, which is nothing more than a precursor of a tornado. If the mesocyclone continues to be fed by different air masses from a storm, it will gradually grow until a funnel is formed, which descends until it reaches the surface, and then a tornado will form. A typical tornado is divided into several distinct parts from each other. The most characteristic section of a tornado is the funnel, which consists of the external visible part that extends from the ground to the clouds. The most dangerous part of a tornado is the base, because that's where the funnel meets the Earth's surface and where the most of the destruction occurs. The winds are the most robust there and the atmospheric pressure is lower. Inside the base are the extremely strong gusts of wind that swirl around the funnel. These gusts can reach incredible speeds and are responsible for most of a tornado's damage. Finally, we have the mother cloud, the storm cloud from which the tornado is detached. It usually consists of a large, dense cumulonimbus cloud that forms in association with severe thunderstorms. There are several types of tornadoes, classified according to how they formed and their intensity. The most common tornadoes are supercell tornadoes, which originate from the above-mentioned supercell storms. These tornadoes are the largest, longest-lasting, most destructive, and most significant, reaching several miles before dissipating. Another type of tornado is the wedge tornado, which is characterized by a wide cone shape at the base. Due to their size and strength, wedge tornadoes are usually very destructive, although they are less common. Finally, multiple tornadoes are another interesting phenomenon where two or more tornadoes form and revolve around the same storm system. These events can be even more dangerous as the area of destruction is more extensive and can therefore wipe out larger areas. As we can see, the formation of a tornado requires extreme conditions and the presence of different factors that are only present in very few places on the planet. The only places on the planet where the conditions for tornado formation are present are South Africa, much of Europe, except most of the Alps, Western and Eastern Australia, New Zealand, Bangladesh, Eastern India, Japan, the Philippines, Canada, and a large area in South America where the countries of Argentina converge, Bolivia, Brazil, Paraguay, and Uruguay. However, the two places with the highest tornado presence are the USA and South America, the only two places with tornado corridors. The most famous is Tornado Alley. It's a vast region in the central U.S. where tornadoes are more conducive and cover parts of Texas, Oklahoma, Kansas, and Nebraska. The second tornado corridor is the one found in South America, in the region known as the Humid Pampas. In this region, all the conditions are present for the formation of tornadoes and intense storms, due to the great extension of the Pampean Plain. The cold air coming from Patagonia and Antarctica collides with the hot, humid, and fast air coming from areas of Brazil, the northern region of Argentina, and Paraguay, to which is added the dry air coming from the Andes Mountains. This combination produces intense storms that manage to reach supercell status very frequently, and many generate intense hail and tornadoes. Although it is known that tornadoes in South America have a lower intensity than those in the US and are not as frequent, that could change in the future due to climate change and especially the destruction of the Amazon rainforest. Faster and faster winds. As the planet experiences global warming, scientists are recording stronger and stronger winds in different areas. Wind speed is one of the most impactful characteristics of a tornado. The winds associated with these whirlwinds can reach incredible speeds, often exceeding 200 miles per hour in extreme cases. This devastating force is capable of ripping a house from its base and even uprooting trees. However, if the winds get faster, this could lead to increasingly destructive tornadoes. Differences in atmospheric temperature between different regions create differences in air density and therefore atmospheric pressure. These pressure differences generate what meteorologists call a pressure gradient, which drives the movement of air, i.e., wind. The greater the temperature difference between the two areas, the higher the pressure gradient, and therefore the higher the wind speed. This means that as the temperature differences increase, the bigger the tornadoes will become, as they will have much faster winds. This will be observed mainly in the areas where these pressure gradients are more noticeable, i.e. in the areas referred to as tornado corridors. However, as global temperatures rise, the conditions needed for a tornado to occur could begin to be present in regions where tornadoes have never been seen before. This would mean that some countries worldwide could start experiencing tornadoes, and countries with them, such as the US, will have increasingly destructive tornadoes. The Fujita scale is the measurement system that indicates the scale of destruction of tornadoes based on wind speed. This ranges from F0 to F5, with F5 being the most devastating tornadoes. These can have winds of up to 318 miles per hour, as they can lift an entire house into the air and even uproot an entire building from the base. These types of tornadoes are the most destructive there can be. Still, suppose global temperatures continue to change within a very short time. In that case, we will have even more destructive tornadoes, with strong winds that would ultimately go off the Fujita scale and be renamed with a new category. Perhaps supertornadoes? And the same curiosity, we think it would be a good name for this type of tornado. But we want your opinion. What name would you give a tornado that exceeds the F5 scale? These supertornadoes would be entirely off the existing scales, exceeding the wind speeds that an F5 class tornado reaches. They could reach winds of up to 400 miles per hour. With that force, these supertornadoes could clean the area where they pass entirely, uprooting everything in their path. Houses, trees, buildings, lifting them into the sky and then dropping them hundreds of miles away. The force of the wind would be so great that it would cause a whirlwind of rocks and debris around it, impacting all the structures that would be left standing. Super tornadoes are undoubtedly one of the most destructive and devastating events. But is it possible that they will ever come into existence? One of the most crucial debates in the study of tornadoes is how climate change may affect the frequency and intensity of these events. While science is still in the process of fully understanding this relationship, some theories and observations are worth considering. Rising global temperatures due to climate change could create more favorable atmospheric conditions for the formation of severe storms, and thus increasingly powerful tornadoes. However, other scientists warn that the picture is more complicated, and that more research is still needed to understand how climate change affects tornadoes. Changes in atmospheric patterns could cause some areas to experience an increase in the frequency and intensity of tornadoes, while others could see a decrease. Ultimately, what is clear is that tornadoes will continue to be a severe and constant threat as we face the challenges of climate change. We must continue investigating and monitoring these events to understand their behavior better and take practical steps to protect ourselves. Now, we want to know your opinion. Will climate change cause super tornadoes in the future? Let us know what you think in the comments.